सभी को शुभेच्छा, हैप्पी थॉट्स। तेज ज्ञान फाउंडेशन एक चैरिटेबल ट्रस्ट है। 20 से अधिक सालों से कार्यरत इस संस्था का मुख्य लक्ष्य है उच्चतम विकसित समाज का निर्माण करना, अर्थात ऐसा समाज जहां विश्व का हर इंसान आनंदित है और अपनी उच्चतम अवस्था से हर कार्य कर रहा है, हर निर्णय ले रहा है, जहां हर इंसान भयमुक्त, चिंता रहित, सीधा, सरल, सहज और शक्तिशाली जीवन जी रहा है। इस लक्ष्य प्राप्ति के लिए संस्था में जीवन के पांचों भाग जैसे कि शारीरिक, मानसिक, सामाजिक, आर्थिक तथा आध्यात्मिक पर विकास कार्य होता है। शारीरिक स्तर पर कार्य करने हेतु संपूर्ण स्वास्थ्य शिविर तथा मानसिक भाग के अंतर्गत हर उम्र के लोगों के लिए अलग अलग कार्यक्रम हैं, जैसे बच्चों को निर्भय बनाने के लिए अभय वरदान, बच्चों के अंदर प्रेम और शांति लाने के लिए शांति वरदान, युवाओं के लिए नीम 90 चरित्रवान कैसे बने, महिलाओं के लिए आत्मनिर्भर नारी कैसे बने, डॉक्टर्स, टीचर्स, पुलिस, आर्मी, बिजनेसमैन तथा कर्मचारियों के लिए तनाव मुक्त जीवन कैसे जिए, फैमिली शिविर, ध्यान शिविर, विश्व शांति अभियान, रक्तदान शिविर, वृक्षारोपण, जेल के बंदियों के लिए तथा अनाथालय के निवासियों के लिए कार्यक्रम, ऐसे विभिन्न कार्यक्रमों द्वारा सामाजिक भाग पर कार्य किया जाता है। इसके अलावा ऐसे कई सारे विषयों पर तेज ज्ञान फाउंडेशन से मार्गदर्शन मिलता है, जिसमें आर्थिक स्तर पर कार्य होता है। 18 साल से अधिक के उम्र के लोगों के लिए महा आसमानी परम ज्ञान शिविर, 14 से 16 तक की उम्र के युवाओं के लिए मिनी महा आसमानी शिविर जैसे विविध शिविर आध्यात्मिक भाग में शामिल हैं। इस तरह तेज ज्ञान फाउंडेशन आत्म विकास से आत्म साक्षात्कार प्राप्त करने की एक सुंदर व्यवस्था है और यह परिवर्तन मात्र श्रवण से संभव है। संक्षेप में कहें तो विश्व शांति लाने हेतु इस संस्था द्वारा ये विभिन्न कार्यक्रम आयोजित किए जाते हैं जो पूर्णतः सर श्री की शिक्षाओं पर आधारित हैं। संस्था के कार्य की सराहना करते हुए कई मान्यवरों ने इस अव्यक्तिगत कार्य में भाग लिया, इसे प्रोत्साहन दिया और शुभेच्छा दी। तेज ज्ञान फाउंडेशन में हर स्तर के लोगों के लिए बड़े पैमाने पर गर्भ संस्कार से मृत्यु उपरांत जीवन तक समावेश सभी विषयों पर मार्गदर्शन उपलब्ध है। तेज ज्ञान फाउंडेशन 450 से अधिक शाखाओं द्वारा भारत में विस्तारित है। इसके अलावा विदेशों में लगभग 25 देशों में साधक फैले हुए हैं। इनमें से तेज ज्ञान फाउंडेशन की एक मुख्य शाखा पिंपरी पुणे में है। संस्था का आश्रम जिसे मनन आश्रम कहा जाता है, वहाँ पर संस्था के अधिकतम शिविर आयोजित किए जाते हैं। मनन आश्रम पुणे शहर के बाहरी क्षेत्र में पहाड़ों और निसर्ग के असीम सौंदर्य के बीच बसा हुआ है। ऐसे सुंदर वातावरण में हम आसानी से आंतरिक शांति की यात्रा कर पाते हैं। अब तक लगभग 1,00,000 से ज्यादा लोगों ने महा आसमानी परम ज्ञान शिविर का लाभ लिया है। इस संस्था द्वारा साहित्य विश्व में विभिन्न विषयों पर 688 से अधिक पुस्तकें प्रकाशित की गई हैं, जिसमें 50 से ज्यादा बेस्ट सेलर पुस्तकें हैं। इन पुस्तकों से हम आध्यात्मिक विकास, स्वमदद, हर समस्या का समाधान और जीवन के गहरे सत्य जान सकते हैं। आज के डिजिटल युग में तेज ज्ञान फाउंडेशन की जानकारी एवं बहुत से संदेश YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, व्हाट्सएप, रेडियो विविध भारती, ऑनलाइन रेडियो इत्यादि पर आसानी से उपलब्ध है। यूट्यूब पर तेज ज्ञान का ऑफिशियल चैनल भी है, जिस पर अलग अलग विषयों पर संदेश उपलब्ध है। तेज ज्ञान फाउंडेशन धर्म निरपेक्ष और ना नफा ना नुकसान इस तत्व पर कार्य करने वाली यानी नॉन प्रॉफिट मेकिंग संस्था है। स्वबोध में स्थापित सर श्री जी द्वारा इस संस्था की स्थापना हुई। हैप्पी थॉट्स यानी शुभ विचार फैलाना संस्था का बुनियादी सिद्धांत है। तेज ज्ञान फाउंडेशन का मूल तत्व यानी समझ है सब मान्यताओं का खेल है। समझ अपने आप में पूर्ण है यानी एवरीथिंग इज अ गेम ऑफ बिलीव्स, अंडरस्टैंडिंग इज द होल थिंग। समझ में आने से सभी गलत मान्यताएं, धारणाएं जो दुख का कारण बनती हैं, वे टूट सकती हैं। आज विश्व को किसी नए धर्म की नहीं बल्कि सभी धर्मों को जोड़ने वाले धागे की जरूरत है। वह धागा है समझ का। तेज ज्ञान फाउंडेशन में समझ के इस धागे पर कार्य किया जाता है। इस संस्था को ISO 9001:2015 से प्रमाणित किया गया है और यह विश्व की ऐसी आध्यात्मिक संस्था है जिसकी विशेषता है उसकी सिस्टम फॉर विजडम अर्थात ज्ञान प्रदान करने की अनोखी कार्य प्रणाली। तेज ज्ञान एक विशिष्ट क्रम से दिया जाता है। यहाँ पर प्रज्ञा जगाने के लिए निश्चित कार्य पद्धति का उपयोग किया जाता है। तेज ज्ञान फाउंडेशन की यह खूबसूरती है कि यहाँ एक एक कदम करके उच्चतम ज्ञान सहजता से दिया जाता है। पहले स्तर पर जो अनुभव दिया जाता है वही अनुभव दूसरे स्तर के लिए बुनियाद का काम करता है, इसलिए इसे संपूर्ण ज्ञान प्रणाली कहा गया है। श्रवण के मार्ग द्वारा हमारी समझ यानी अंडरस्टैंडिंग पर कार्य किया जाता है क्योंकि उद्देश्य है समझ को उजागर करना। यहाँ हम जो सत्य श्रवण करते हैं जिससे हमारी समझ बढ़ती है और जीवन में उसी तरह जीना हम शुरू करते हैं। इसे एक शब्द में हम कह सकते हैं नॉलेरियंस यानी नॉलेज प्लस एक्सपीरियंस अर्थात ज्ञान और अनुभव का जोड़। विश्व शांति और शुभ विचारों की क्रांति लाने के लिए इस स्वयं सेवी संस्था के अनेक स्वयं सेवक जो डॉक्टर्स टीचर्स इंजीनियर्स महिलाएं और युवा वर्ग के भी हैं जो अपना कार्य संभालते हुए स्व इच्छा से निरंतर सेवा कार्य कर रहे हैं। तेज ज्ञान की यह जानकारी एक झलक मात्र है। वास्तव में तेज ज्ञान बहुत गहरा विशाल तथा अंतिम ज्ञान है। यदि आप भी अपना जीवन तेज ज्ञान के प्रकाश में उच्चतम की ओर लेकर जाना चाहते हैं तो अवश्य महा आसमानी परम ज्ञान शिविर करें, मनन आश्रम को भेंट दें या YouTube पर संदेश का लाभ लें। धन्यवाद। हैप्पी थॉट्स।
तेज ज्ञान इज ऑफर्ड बाय सर श्री। सर श्री स्पिरिचुअल क्वेस्ट बिगन एज अ चाइल्ड लीडिंग हिम थ्रू वेरियस स्कूल्स ऑफ थॉट्स टीचिंग्स एंड प्रैक्टिसेस ऑफ मेडिटेशन। इन एंड थ्रू ईच ऑफ दीज ही वाज लेफ्ट डिससैटिस्फाइड फीलिंग दैट देयर वाज अ मिसिंग लिंक। हिज थर्स्ट टू स्पेंड मोर एंड मोर टाइम इन द सर्च फॉर ट्रुथ लेड हिम to relinquish his role of a college lecturer. He undertook a long period of contemplation on the mystery of life till his quest ended on enlightenment. Sir Shri realized that the lack of understanding was the missing link in all paths leading to truth. Sir Shri has delivered more than 1,000 discourses on truth as well as on various aspects of practical living. He is an amazing ability of conveying the subtlest understanding through casual contemporary language. The highest aspects of truth are woven into analogies and humor that provoke one to contemplate. Sir Shri is a spiritual maestro whose key teaching is that all paths that led to truth begin differently but end in the same way with understanding. Everything is game of beliefs. Understanding is the whole thing and this understanding is complete in itself.
This was a short introduction of Tej Gyan Foundation and Sir Shri Ji. So we will move further with this session. It was necessary to know by whom we are going to get some things today and what is Tej Gyan Foundation. So as I started with the intro of Tej Gyan Foundation, that it basically works on creating the highly evolved society. For that purpose, many programs are taken by foundation. So this stress management program is also part of all that programs, which we conduct for we conduct on demand also, and for various categories of the society we conduct that program. So today, to start with, Sarshi says that there are 5 parts of our life. So why we are starting with this topic? Because we are talking on stress today. So what is stress, how it comes, and what are the tools, what are the techniques, and what are the solutions for it? Before that, we need to understand some basic things which we might be knowing already, but from a new point of view, for understanding stress management topic, we will go through these things. So as Sarshi says that there are 5 parts of our life. If we balance all the parts of our life, then we can live a happy, balanced life. So the 5 parts are physical, mental, social, financial, and spiritual. So what Sarshi says that if we want to define a happy man, if we want to know the definition of real happiness, then what the real definition of happiness can be? A man who is balanced in all his 5 parts of life. For example, if someone is physically fit, he is doing the exercise, his diet is nice, his everything is nice, and he is living, his physical part is very fit, but he has less money in his life. Money is less, means financial part is less, then he will not be happy. A person is financially fit, but is physically not strong. He is having some diseases, and he is spending more money in the hospital, he is spending more money after the doctors, then also he is not happy. Somebody is physically fit, having more money, but mentally is not stable. Mentally he is not having positivity. Most of the time he is negative. Then also he is not happy. Someone is good in all these 3 areas, but his social part is not good. Social part means his relations in the family, relations in the relatives, in the society, in the business, in the job, wherever he is. So if relations are not good, then also he is not happy. So what Sarshi tries to tell that all the 5 planes should be balanced equally, physically also, mentally also, socially also, financially also, and the last part is most important, spiritual. When we cover all the aspects of our area, but still we are not feeling good from inside, we are not feeling complete from inside, there is no completeness inside there, then comes the spiritual part. The spiritual journey takes us to that point where we feel completeness. Why we are on the earth? What is the real intention of life? What we are doing actually? Are we really happy? Why we are not really happy? So the spiritual journey takes us to that point. So all these 5 aspects of life are very, very important. So when a person works on all these aspects, then he lives a happy life. So Tejgyan Foundation Sarshi ji guides how to attend all the parts simultaneously, parallelly, at a time. So we need to focus on all the things. Otherwise, a person may have goals of financial goals, that I want to earn this much money. It is not bad. We should have goals like that. But he is just running after money, and his physical planes, his relations are not that good. Then after getting that money also, he will not be happy. So we need to attend all the 5 aspects of our life. So all these programs guides us, Sarshi ji guides how to attend this balanced life. Sarshi ji says one simple, a very beautiful statement, that a poor man can be happy, but a happy man can never be poor. Right? Please hear it again. A poor man can be happy, but a happy man can never be poor. So here the poorness is not related to money only. It is related to the abundance on all the aspects of your life. Whether you are physically abundant, whether you are mentally abundant, whether you are socially abundant, whether you are financially abundant, whether you are spiritually abundant. Then if you are abundant on all these aspects, then you can never be poor, right? So today we are going to know all these things from Sarshi ji. So to start with our topic, stress management, I would like all the participants to chat in the chat box at least minimum one reason or one factor or one parameter which is responsible for your stress. For example, for some of us, it may be the lockdown. For some of us, it may be the online teaching style. Now we have to teach online. Earlier, it was we were teaching physically, going in the classroom and doing all the things. But lockdown has changed so many things for us. So whether the teaching online, learning new things, learning high-tech things can be a stressful things, or the job can be stressful, or relations, or home, whatever. So I would like, I will give a minute to all of you to write in the chat box. I will not go through the oral sharings, but in the chat box, everybody can type what are the various factors which are responsible for stress in our life. Okay, Hiranji has typed thinking about future, money, work-life balance, worry about the future. Okay, good. Dr. Solani Patil has typed that. Okay, finance. So there are 96 participants. I would like everybody to get activated on the chat box, right? So please, so that we can understand what kind of stress parameters are there. Not getting salary, okay? Current state of life, job security, no proper time and work management. Yes, I would like everybody to at least type one reason. Job security, finance. Okay. Sometimes family. Okay, good. Sometimes it is family, not always. The main reason are job security, future, finance. I will get more 20 seconds. Managing kids at home. Oh, yes, Nidhi madam, managing kids at home. Okay. So I would again request all the participants who can easily keep their videos on. Only one video is on. So I am thankful to Professor Belkar J.A. whose video is on. So I am thankful to him. Nidhi madam will also start it. Okay, so it can be an interactive one. I am not able to see the reactions of the participants. Okay, society can be there. Anxiety can be there. Okay, these are the factors of stress. Okay. Now there is another question. Next level. Right. If we feel that these are the parameters and these are the reasons from which we are stressed sometimes, or we are in pain, we are unhappy because of these factors. So when we say stress, when you are saying that today I'm in too much stress, today I'm in too much stress, when you are saying that, in which part of the body you are feeling the stress? So the question is, you have to type the part of the body where you feel that stress. Actually you feel it. If you are not feeling it, then type nowhere. Okay, sometimes mental stress. Mental means headache. Okay. Okay, we can take that in the head. Okay, mind. Okay, head, leg. Okay, sometimes leg. Okay. At feeling level, mind, right? Okay, neck and head. Okay, while typing the stress factors, you should smile and type, okay? So that is also a tool to lower down your stress. Increase in pulse rate, okay. Whenever the stress level is very high, then it happens that it is increase in a pulse rate. Okay, good. So mostly, but when we go deep inside this topic, when we are talking about the stress, what the human psychology says or what the scientists have done, the experiments, whenever we are saying generally that today I am stressed, then the first tool that we should use is what? You should ask ourselves one question. Where actually I am feeling the stress physically? Most of the time, 90% of the time, it is only mentally. It is only in the thoughts. It is not physically you are feeling that stress. 90% of the time, it is in thoughts. So the major reason behind major stress are our thoughts. The kind of thoughts we are going through, or the kind of thoughts at that moment which we are feeling or thinking, that are more responsible for our stress. So when we are going towards the solution for stress management, the first thing we need to focus on is our thoughts. So whatever we attract in our life is all through the thoughts. Mind, what is mind? Mind and brain are two different things. Brain is a physical thing which we have here somewhere, you know, this part. This is brain. But what is mind? Man, in Hindi. Man ko kya bolte? What is mind? Mind is a bundle of thoughts. It is not present physically somewhere. It is just a bundle of thoughts to which we call it as mind. So whenever there is stress, it is most of the time, 90% of the time, it is mental. Mentally, we are feeling stress. Only because of the thoughts. So the journey starts from negative thoughts to positive thoughts, and positive thoughts to happy thoughts. So positive thoughts are not the final thing. You know? So from so many years, we have heard that we should be positive, we should have positive thoughts. But beyond that, the next stage is happy thoughts. Right? The thoughts which are filled with the right understanding. Thoughts which are filled with the right knowledge. Knowledge and information, again, are two different things. Information is just which we get from whatever we are looking, seeing, hearing, and doing things like that. Knowledge is which is through experience, what you are experiencing from inside. That is knowledge. So, from positive thoughts to happy thoughts. Whenever we are in the happy thought state, then our stress level will go down. Because in the happy thought state, we are having the right experience from inside about all the incidents happening in front of us. Whether it is in the job, whether it is in the relations, whether it is in the house, whether it is with the kids, whether it is with the salary, whatever it is. It's our thinking and sometimes overthinking which creates stress itself. Stress is never created from outside. So what I'm telling is, it's a very deep thought. Please catch it. Stress is never created from outside. It is always created from inside through our thoughts, through our thinkings. And that also happens from whatever knowledge or whatever experience we are having. Right? So, yes, many times there are multiple thoughts running in mind and we are dragged between different thoughts. Yes, that's right. So Dr. Sonali Patel had typed that. So there are many thoughts, you know, so many thoughts going around. And thoughts are not in our hand. We cannot say, stop thoughts, don't come. We cannot say that. Thoughts will come always. So today we will learn some techniques, how to watch them, how to grab the thoughts, or to which thoughts we should entertain, positive thoughts or negative thoughts or happy thoughts. It's in our hand. The remote control should be in our hand. Now I'm going through the second deep thought. Please grab it. The remote control should be in our hand. We have always given our remote control in others' hand. If this person doesn't behave as we want, if the faculty doesn't behave as we want, if the kids doesn't behave as we want, we get hyper, we get tense, we get unhappy, we are in anger. So the person in front of us has pushed one button of anger through various incidents or through various thoughts given by him, and we are angry. But it should be not like that. It should be whatever he is doing, but it is my choice that what I will give the response. It should not be compulsive. It should be decisive. It should be your decision. How should I respond to each and every incident in my life? It should not be a compulsion. But today we are living a compulsive life, which we have programmed from so many years by so many incidents with us. It is not our fault also, because the subconscious mind within us is being programmed like that. If my kids don't hear me, I have to slap them, right? If the student don't hear me, I have to say something different. I have to shout at them. This programming we need to change. So the reason for stress, what we heard, is it is not from outside, it's from inside. And what science says, that we can train ourselves, we can reprogram our subconscious mind, that we can be happy in any kind of incident, whether it is negative, positive, whatever it is, but still we can be in a happy state. It is up to us. So today what we will learn? We will learn a very beautiful tool from Sarshi ji, that how to approach, how to face the incidents in our life which make us stressful, and how to apply that tool. So now I will again share my screen. Before that, we will do one exercise, right? So it's a kind request again, for minimum for this exercise, please all of you start your video, because I have to watch this you are doing or not. Okay. So the exercise is, you all need to have one handkerchief in your hand. If it is in your pocket or somewhere around, you can have one handkerchief. So I will give you 30, 40 seconds, please. And take handkerchief only. It should not be towels, which are very thick. So we have to do something with handkerchief. So it should be thin, not thick. Okay. Chalo. Yes. So please take handkerchief in your hands. Please start your videos. Otherwise, I will not be able to understand whether people are doing or not. We are running. So we have still 45 minutes. So we have to complete the topic in that. Okay. So I hope that everybody has taken the handkerchief, because I'm not able to see. Nobody is ready to on their video. So what you have to do, in your handkerchief, you have to tie 3 knots in any place. 3 knots like this. 1, then 2. So all have taken their lunch. So you are filled with energy. So do it. The knot should be tight. 3 knots or minimum 2 knots you should do on your handkerchief like this. Okay. Done. Okay. So please go through the instructions now. When I will say start, you have to hold that handkerchief in one hand. If you are right-handed, you have to hold it in your right hand. Sorry. If you are right-handed, you have to hold it in your left hand. And you have to put your right hand behind your back like this. If you are lefty, do vice versa. Okay. So you all are okay. Chalo. All are holding their handkerchief with 3 knots with one hand only. When I will say start, so what you have to do, you have to open the knots without using any other part of your body. Only the hand you are holding with that hand only, you have to open the 3 knots. When I will say start, when I will say stop, you have to stop. No other part of the body, right? Otherwise you will use your teeth and not like that. Only the hand in which you are holding your handkerchief. Okay, you will get 20 seconds. Not more than that. Okay, chalo, we are starting now. I will keep the timer. Chalo, start. Start with that one hand. At least try. Please try, okay? Okay, Joseph ji has opened it already. Good. Everybody start. 10 seconds are over. Last 10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stop. Some of you were able to open it. It might be that you might have not tightened it properly. Okay. Thank you for participating in this wonderful exercise. Now, why we have done this exercise? So when we come to Tej Gyan Foundation and when Sarshi is going to deliver something, so there is a system in the foundation that we play some exercises or do some activity so that we can understand what Sarshi is trying to say in the discourse or in the next sandesh. What we say in Hindi, it is pravachan or a lecture from him. So first we will listen from him the lecture, what he is trying to say. Then again we will, and after that lecture, I will again explain what we have done in this exercise and why we have done. There is a very powerful technique which is going to tell us from today only we will apply in our life and get our stress lower to 90-95% directly. Okay. So the lecture will be in Hindi. It may be some English subtitles may be there. So we can hear it. After that, I will again explain on that. So I will start my screen and then we will go through the lecture by Sarshi. Yes, Niji madam, screen is visible?
Yes, sir, it is visible.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
प्यारे सत्य के खोजियों, अब सबको शुभेच्छा. Happy thoughts. अब बात आती है कि सुखड़ा हुआ इंसान और खुला हुआ इंसान, इसके बीच में जो गैप है ये कैसे भर जाए. सुखड़ा हुआ यानी रेजिस्टेंस, प्रतिरोध, प्रतिरोध. ऐसा हो रहा नहीं, ऐसा हो रहा नहीं, कुछ तो रोक रहा, रुके रुके, ये आए नहीं, नजदीक नहीं आए, दूर हो. तो ये सुखड़ा हुआ और ये खुला हुआ. अभी हम यहां हैं, हमें यहां पहुंचना है, बीच में गैप है. इस गैप को भरने के लिए एक मंत्र है जो हम रिपीट करने वाले हैं. रिपीट करेंगे कब? जब हम सुकुड़ने लगे तब, जब दुख की घटना हो तब, जब परेशानी का विचार आए तब, तब ये मंत्र इस्तेमाल करना है. मंत्र क्या है? सिंपल सा मंत्र है, सिर्फ ये इशारा किया आपने तो ये मंत्र हो गया. सिर्फ उंगलियों को इस तरह किया तो ये मंत्र हो गया. ये उंगलियां इस तरह क्या दिखा रही? ब्रैकेट. हम कोई चीज ब्रैकेट में लिखते हैं तो इस तरफ भी ऐसा करते, इस तरफ भी ऐसा करते, उसको कहते ब्रैकेट. तो खाली आपको अपने आप से एक सवाल पूछना है. जब भी कोई घटना हो दुखद, जब भी किसी ने परेशान किया, अंदर से विचार आया परेशानी का, डर आया, कोई भी घटना अंदर से आई हुई या बाहर से आई हुई, तो अपने आप को खाली ये सवाल पूछना है, ये मंत्र दोहराना, क्या मैं यह स्वीकार कर सकता हूं, क्या मैं यह स्वीकार कर सकता हूं. कैन आई एक्सेप्ट दिस, कैन आई एक्सेप्ट दिस, क्या मैं यह स्वीकार कर सकता हूं. ब्रैकेट में यह, यानी जो भी ब्रैकेट में है, समझो. इस वक्त आपको कहा गया कि अभी 2 घंटे और प्रवचन चलने वाला है, अरे बाप रे, हम तो भूल करनी है, कुछ शुरू हो जाए, क्या मैं ये स्वीकार कर सकता हूं. पूछोगे क्या मैं ये स्वीकार कर सकता हूं, एक सवाल अपने आप से पूछोगे. घर गए, घंटी बजाई, जल्दी कोई दरवाजा ही नहीं खुल रहा है, बहुत गुस्सा आ रहा है ना, अरे दरवाजा क्यों नहीं खुल रहा, क्या मैं यह स्वीकार कर सकता, दरवाजा देरी से खुले, क्या मैं ये स्वीकार कर सकता हूं. ये ब्रैकेट है. जो भी घटना हो रही हो, जो भी हो रहा हो, आप रास्ते से जा रहे हैं, कोई आपके ऊपर हंसा, चला गया, अब बुरा लग रहा है, अरे मेरे ऊपर हंसा, मुझे ऐसा कहा, तो सिर्फ अपने आप से अंदर ही पूछना, क्या मैं यह स्वीकार कर सकता हूं. यह यानी मुझ पर हंसना, ब्रैकेट में मुझ पर हंसा, क्या मैं ये स्वीकार कर सकता हूं. फला पर्सन को काम दिया, उसने किया ही नहीं, बड़ा गुस्सा आ रहा, क्या मैं यह स्वीकार कर सकता हूं. खाली बस ये इशारा जो किया, ये ब्रैकेट है, ये ब्रैकेट इशारा है कि क्या ये स्वीकार कर सकता हूं, जो भी चल रहा है जीवन, स्वीकार करते ही किनारा मिट गया। किनारा मिट गया, जो पानी है विलीन हो गया, दुख विलीन हो गया। दुख को किनारा दोगे, जमा होगा, जमा होगा, जमा होगा, क्योंकि हम रेजिस्ट कर करके जमा करते दुख, उसको विलीन होने नहीं देते। टेलीफोन किसी को लगा रहा है, घंटी बज रही है और उठा रहा नहीं है, उसको पर्सन गुस्सा आ रहा है, अरे उठा रहा क्यों नहीं रहा है, जल्दी उठा क्यों नहीं रहा है। अपने आप से पूछना, क्या मैं यह स्वीकार कर सकता, यह यानी टेलीफोन जल्दी न उठाना, टेलीफोन जल्दी न उठाना, क्या मैं यह स्वीकार कर सकता हूं। जवाब आएगा यस, जवाब आएगा यस। छोटी घटना में तो 100% घटनाओं में यस जवाब आएगा, छोटी छोटी बातों में। बहुत सुबह से देखो रात तक कितनी बातें होती छोटी छोटी जो पसंद नहीं आती है। तो घंटी बज रही, सामने उठा रहा नहीं, क्या मैं स्वीकार कर सकता, यस। फिर आप आराम से फोन पकड़ के बैठे हो, यस बोलने के बाद एक दो तीन आराम से गिन रहे हैं कितनी बार की बात उठाता है। स्वीकार करने के साथ ही मजा आ रहा है इसका, क्योंकि रेजिस्टेंस खत्म हो गया। देखो एक ट्रेन से लोग यात्रा करते हैं, बच्चे भी होते, बड़े भी होते, बूढ़े भी होते। जब ट्रेन से उतरते हैं लोग तो बड़े थके थके महसूस होते, बहुत टायर्ड। अरे किया क्या ट्रेन में बैठ के, किया तो कुछ भी नहीं। और बच्चे फ्रेश होते वो स्टेशन पर उतर के नाचते, इधर भागते उधर भागते। क्यों बच्चे क्यों है, क्योंकि जब ट्रेन आगे धक्का दे रही थी तो आगे हो रहे थे, जब पीछे धक्का दे रहे थे पीछे हो रहे थे। मगर बड़ा इंसान क्या कर रहा था, जब आगे धक्का दे रहे थे पीछे हो रहे थे, पीछे धक्का था आगे हो रहे थे। तो बच्चों में कैसा था वो स्वीकार, ऑटोमेटिक है बच्चों में, क्योंकि वो अभी केंद्र के नजदीक है, सेंटर के नजदीक है, हार्ट के नजदीक है, तेजस्थान के नजदीक है, तो मजे से स्वीकार करता है, मजा आता है। आगे हो गया, अरे वाह, और पीछे हो रहे, अभी आगे हो रहे, मजा आ रहा है। बड़ा बोलता, अरे नहीं नहीं आगे कर रहा था, मुझे पीछे होना चाहिए, ये स्वीकार नहीं, ये भी स्वीकार नहीं, ये भी नहीं, ये भी नहीं, ये भी नहीं, ये भी नहीं। पूरी देर यात्रा, पूरी जीवन की यात्रा ऐसे ही बीत जाती है। अब खाली ये मंत्र दोहराना, मंत्र का एक सवाल है, क्या मैं यह स्वीकार कर सकता, ये ब्रैकेट का सिंबल है। कभी बोलने की जरूरत, सिर्फ ऐसा पूछोगे अपने आप से, यस यस हो सकता है। सामने वाला पर्सन आ रहा है और आपको बिल्कुल पसंद नहीं है, हाँ यस। घर एक ही फैमिली मेंबर हो तो एक दूसरे को याद भी दिलाएंगे, भाई देखो किसको गुस्सा आ रहा है। करो स्वीकार करो, तुरंत सुकड़न बन, नहीं के साथ ही सुकड़ गए, हाँ स्वीकार, मैं स्वीकार, यस यस के साथ खुल गए, आराम से बैठे हैं। 2 घंटे प्रवचन और चलेगा। जो तालियां बजा रहे वो खुश है बहुत। बाकी सब जरा सचमुच तो नहीं होगा ऐसा। तो यस, जैसे यस आया तो प्रॉब्लम है ही नहीं, नो आया तो क्या करना है, तब पॉज देना है। जब नो आए तो पॉज देना, उस वक्त क्या कहना, अच्छा ये अस्वीकार हो रहा है, पहले तो इस अस्वीकार को स्वीकार करता हूं, अस्वीकार को स्वीकार, नहीं हो रहा ना स्वीकार, ठीक है इसको तो स्वीकार करते, दुख आया है ना, ठीक है दुख को तो स्वीकार करते, दुखी रहते, मैं दुख पर दुख नहीं बनाएंगे, दुख आया क्यों दुख आया, नहीं आना चाहिए, तनाव आया क्यों तनाव आया, नहीं आना चाहिए था, नहीं आना चाहिए, ठीक है तनाव आया ना स्वीकार, तनाव आया ना स्वीकार, गुस्सा आया है स्वीकार, अस्वीकार हो रहा है स्वीकार, अस्वीकार को भी स्वीकार, नहीं हो रहा है स्वीकार इसको भी स्वीकार, पॉज। यस के बाद कोई तकलीफ है ही नहीं, नो के बाद देना पॉज, पहले अस्वीकार को स्वीकार करना, फिर पॉज, फिर थोड़ी देर के बाद वापस पूछना, क्या ये स्वीकार कर सकते हो, फिर देखो यस आएगा। 2 बार मन बोलेगा नहीं नहीं नहीं, 4 बार बोलेगा नहीं नहीं नहीं, फिर पॉज देंगे, फिर पूछेंगे अभी स्वीकार हो रहा है, अभी तो देखो कि जल्द से जल्द उससे घटना से बाहर आओगे। पहले दिनों दिन महीनों महीने लग रहे थे। कुछ लोग तो बोलते फला पर्सन को मैं 7 जन्म नहीं भूल सकता, 7 जन्म तक वो स्वीकार नहीं कर पाता। मगर पहुंच देखे फिर से पूछते रहोगे ना, यस आएगा। हम बेहोश हो जाते ना, इसलिए यस आता नहीं। ये सवाल है जागृत करने के लिए, होश में लाने, सवाल इसलिए होते। फिर एक ही सवाल बचता है, अरे हम ऐसा स्वीकार करेंगे तो फिर क्या हम वैसे ही रह जाए, कोई इम्प्रूवमेंट ही नहीं होगी। अच्छा ये काम नहीं कर रहा, ठीक है स्वीकार है, नहीं करने दो, ये ऐसा कर रहा है नहीं करने दो, फिर तो कुछ काम हो गया ही नहीं। ऐसा नहीं है, जैसे ही आप स्वीकार करते हो आपके दोनों हाथ खुल जाते हैं। जब हम अस्वीकार करते हैं, हमने जैसे कि राइट हैंड बांध दिया पीठ पर अस्वीकार, और एक हाथ से फिर हम सॉल्व करते, प्रॉब्लम आया है अस्वीकार करते, एक हाथ बांध देते, फिर एक हाथ से सॉल्व करते, समस्या का समाधान पूरा नहीं होता। स्वीकार किया, दोनों हाथ खुल गए। अब दोनों हाथ खोलकर समस्या को सॉल्व करोगे तो जल्दी सॉल्व होगा। पहले क्या कर रहे थे, एक हाथ बांध कर रहे थे। स्वीकार का अर्थ समझो, ऐसा नहीं कहा फिर कुछ मत करो, वो चीजें वैसे ही रहने दो, शिकायत मत करो, नहीं, पहले स्वीकार करो, फिर अब क्या कर सकते, दोनों हाथ खोलकर खुलकर। ये मंत्र के साथ क्या होगा, दोनों हाथ खोलकर खुलकर समस्या को सॉल्व करोगे। खुलकर खोलकर दोनों हाथों को खोलो, बाद स्वीकार के साथ दोनों हाथ खुल जाएंगे, ये उसका जादू है। ये सब बातें सुनकर यहां आकर जो आप सबने सेवा का मौका दिया, उसके लिए आप सबका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। हैव ए थॉट्स।
यस, हैव ए थॉट्स टू ऑल। सो व्हाट सरशी जी हैज गिवन अस द टूल इज द पावर ऑफ एक्सेप्टेंस, राइट। इन आवर डे टू डे लाइफ so many things from morning to evening, out of 100, 90% of the things are unaccepted by us, due to which we unknowingly are going through the stress, going through the unhappiness, which we should not even go through that. But just because we are not accepting some things, that's why we are going through the pain, that's why we are going through the stress. So in our life, in day-to-day life, there are many things which can be easily accepted. There was no need of accepting them and just accumulating them inside us. From morning, if the light goes off, electricity is cut off, quickly we'll say, oh my God, why it went now only, I have to do so many things. I have to go to the college. I have to do this. I have to do that. Unexpected, unacceptance. But now the light goes. What we say, what Sarshi ji has taught us, a simple, it is said in the words like mantra, but it is a simple question. It is a bracket. We will say, can I accept this? Okay. Right now I can accept this, because you can't do anything for that. Light has gone. What you can do? You are not in the electricity board. What you will do there? You cannot put your finger there and start the lights, right? So what we can now do is just ask a simple question. Okay, can I accept this? Yes. Then okay. By acceptance, what happens inside, as we spoke earlier, stress is not from outside. It is from inside. Unhappiness is not from outside. It is not because of someone else. It is because of us. It is because of our thoughts. So a simple question, a simple bracket, the example which we are taking, the lights off, can I accept it? Yes, I can accept it. What will happen? First of all, the body mind mechanism will get relaxed. Now the mind can open, the flow of thoughts will flow. When we don't accept anything, there is unacceptance. What happens? There is resistance from inside. So much resistance that mind get stuck, flow of thoughts get stuck, starts getting us physically on us, right? And then if you continue to do the unacceptance, then it goes and goes on. So the simple thing is, for example, If a housewife is preparing food early in the morning, he has to prepare the lunch box for his husband, for his children, and she is preparing, and suddenly the cylinder gets over, gas cylinder. Now what happens? From the old programming, oh my God, what happened? Why it happened now only? I have to prepare lunch box for everybody. I have to prepare my breakfast. What will I do? Unacceptance. But when we say, okay, gas cylinder is over, can I accept this? What Sarshi said, then 99% yes will come. Okay, I can accept it, Rahul. Okay, yes, done. The minds get relaxed. Now thoughts will flow. What can we do? We will see other refilling cylinder is available or not. Okay, not available. Then we ask the neighbors. Okay, not done. Then ask the cylinder agency, or we can bring it back. Or today we can announce, housewife can announce, today all the food will be ordered from hotel, and all the, your lunch boxes will be ordered from hotel. In evening also go in the hotel and have our dinner and lunch. Right. But when the unacceptance is there, so many negative thoughts come, so many conflicts arises, and then we are unhappy, and then we are going through the stress. So the power of acceptance tool is given to us today by Sarshi. Right. In Hindi, it is a, can I accept this? Kya main ye swikar kar sakta hun? That's it. We are going to our job. We get a traffic jam. Oh my God, why this happened now? I have to reach in time. I got a meeting. I have to present something. You have seen the traffic jam. Now you are asking yourself one question. Can I accept it now? Yes, we can. Otherwise also, what we can do now when there is a traffic jam? Your car cannot fly. Your bike cannot fly and go somewhere, right? So the thing is, internally we have to solve something. So we'll accept that, okay, traffic jam is there. What can I do? I can inform my boss. I can inform my colleague. I can inform my whatever friends are there who are waiting for me that I have got in a traffic jam. This thing had happened. We will do like this. That's it. And relax. So what Sarshi said, that when we don't accept things, we accumulated inside so much. Matlab wo bhar raha hai andar. It's getting inside us so much things, so that it blocks our mind, it blocks our thoughts, and everything is blocked and negativity starts. So simple question here, 99% of the incidents we get the answer yes only. Sometimes we will not get yes. So what Sarshi ji said, yes, some incidents may be major, where some things are so major that we are unable to accept that thing at that time. So Sarshi ji has said that accept the unacceptance. Okay, I am not able to accept this right now. So this not accepting this right now, I am accepting that. Yeah, I am not accepting that. And after a few hours, again we have to ask it. Can I accept this? Then answer will come yes. So sometimes you have to give the time also. Time solves so many things. We have heard so many times. Right? Time is a healer actually. As the time passes, some things get healed. So if sometime it may happen that each and everything cannot be accepted that time, so we have to take a pause. Okay, I am not accepting this time. This I am accepting. I am not accepting this. Then after a short period of time, again we have to ask the question. Right. So I would like to tell an analogy on that. So that we can, and I have already given some examples. So from today in our life, we will use this power of acceptance tool, right? This lecture, this pravachan is available on VD, on YouTube also. You can search it for power of acceptance, Sarshri ji. You can type the keywords and you will get this pravachan in English also on the YouTube and on Hindi also. There are more than 600 pravachans and lectures by Sarshri ji on YouTube. The Tej Gyan Foundation, Sarshri ji is the official YouTube channels. You can utilize them in your life on different topics like that. So what I was telling, that one analogy about this power of acceptance. There, what power of acceptance does is that it opens us. The exercise we did before this lecture, what was the exercise? With one hand, we were solving. What Sarshi ji said? Yes. So what Sarshi ji said to us is that when we solve the problems with both the hands, with openness, right, then we can solve it creatively or effectively. But when we don't accept anything, what we are doing? We are solving it with one hand. We are not solving it with full-fledged open thoughts, with open mind. So to open up that, we have to accept the thing first, then relax, and then again think on the solutions like that. So there were two frogs. Frogs, you know, there were two frogs. They were both friends. This is just an analogy and a story to explain this. Okay. So kalpanik katha hai. Kalpanik, it is kalpanik katha. It is not resemblance to anybody. So there were two frogs sitting on a roadside. It was a evening time. They both were having a nice chat. One of them was saying that today is a cool breeze. So nice environment, so nice atmosphere. Then we're telling about their life and all. Across the road, there was a factory of something and there was a main gate. So they were chatting and at the same moment, one truck arrived there, stopped in the inside the factory area. The driver got down, he went into the factory. One of the frog, out of curiosity, said to the other frog, come on, let's go and check what is there in that truck. In that truck, there were some cans and some pots. Cans were kept there. Cans of milk. Milk cans are there. So milk cans were kept there. And one of the cans was open. So this frog out of curiosity said, let's go and check what is there in there. So another frog was saying to him that, let it be. It is nice here. Nice breeze is going on. We will have a chit chat. Why to go there and do something like that? He said, no, chalo, as it is, we are not doing anything. We'll go and check. So they went, they jumped on the truck, they jumped on that cant and they were just peeping down inside what is there. So it was a milk cant and there was some milk. And just they were peeping down and the driver came and started the truck with the jerk. They fall inside. Now that both the frogs were inside that cant, the supervisor came and checked, "Arey, how come this is open?" He took and closed that cant. Now the truck started and the truck is going on. Now both the frogs are inside. The frog which was telling that we should not go there, he was in so much anger that he started speaking loudly. "I was telling that we should not come here. See what happened. We got stuck inside. Now what will happen to us? I will die. I will die. I will die." Unacceptance. "I will die. I will die." He was speaking die, die, die. And in the next minute, he lost his breath and he died. But the second frog had attended a seminar like this on stress management and he has heard the power of acceptance. So what he asked himself, "Can I accept this?" He said, "Okay, I can accept this that I have struck inside." Now, as he accepted, the flow of thoughts started, some vague thoughts started coming to him. What kind of thoughts? "If I would had a hammer and a nail, I would have made the hole in this can. And the milk would have gone out and I would have survived," like that. Then so many other thoughts started coming and suddenly he got a eureka effect. He realized, "I am a frog. I can swim. Why am I getting so panicked?" So he started swimming in that milk round and round. So milk was not fully, the can was not filled fully. It was below half. So he started swimming fast in the milk, round and round, 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 round. And we know that when we mush up the milk many times, then it becomes a curd type. Hindi mein bolte loni, Marathi mein loni ho jata hai uska. Gola ho jata hai. So curd type, so it became a curd type. He sat on that. When the supervisor came then, and then he opened and he jumped and he then left off. So the purpose of saying this analogy story was, when acceptance is there, flow of thoughts comes. Then we, with both the hands, we can solve the problems and we can avoid our stress levels like that. So power of acceptance is the most highly recommended and highly powerful tool for lowering down your stress levels in life. So the symbol what Sarshi has shown is like this bracket. So you might have observed on my background, there is a symbol like this. So Tej Gyan Foundation Sastri's first teaching is acceptance, Swikar. When you will sometimes in future visit our Manan Ashram in Pune, which is a 25-acre Manan Ashram, which you might have seen in the videos also. So there also there are statue of Swikar only. There are no statues of Sarshri. We don't advertise Sarshri more. We advertise the teachings more. So the first teaching of foundation is Swikar. And it is the most highly recommended tool, or we can say highly recommended thing in spirituality also. If in day-to-day life, if we are practicing Swikar, acceptance in each and everything, how the life will be? It will be so much free flow. It will be so much happier than ever. So power of acceptance was the tool which has to be given to you today in the stress management program. As I said that in 1.5 hours, we cannot cover stress fully. It is a big chapter, but this tool can help you nicely. So you can again go through other lectures of Sarshi on YouTube also. Now another tool which we want to give you today is in another 10 minutes only, then we'll wrap up with the closing things, whichever Nidhi madam wants to wrap up with in the end. Okay. So the next tool is, when we say that thoughts are everything which creates stress, which creates happiness also, right? So to create good thoughts, happy thoughts, it should not be like that. In Hindi, it is saying, saying is there in Hindi. Jab pyaas lagti hai, toh kuwa nahi khodna hai. Kuwa pehle hi khod ke rakhna hai. Whenever we are thirsty, we don't have to dig the well at that moment. We have to dig the well in advance. So if you want to work on your stress in advance, if you want that in from tomorrow or from today, the incidents happening in front of me, I should be able to accept them quickly, then you have to calm your mind. You have to calm your body mind mechanism. And that is done through meditation, right? From so many years in the Indian history or wherever, meditation is a powerful tool through which we can calm down our thoughts, we can calm down our mind, we can calm down our brain, we can energize ourselves, we can re-energize ourselves. So that is the best tool. So meditation is not like that ki we have to do for 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. That is meditation. Sarshi says that meditation done for 5 minutes also, but with the right understanding. When I'm in the meditation, all my thoughts are in standby, are in parking. For that 5 minutes, you are with the nature. You are with the self, or whatever you are with, your God, Allah, Bhagwan, jisko bhi hum mante hain. For that 5-10 minutes, you are with that source. You are with that origin. So if you are doing meditation for 5 or 10 minutes also with proper understanding, then it will affect your body mind mechanism in a very good way. So right now, what we are going to do, we are going to practice a meditation for just 10 minutes. So it is a guided meditation by Sarshi ji. It will be in Hindi and some English words also. So what we have to do is to sit straight wherever we are sitting. Okay, everybody please sit straight. Then after closing your eyes, we have to take a long breath and leave it. While the breath is going inside, see that each and every part of your body is getting relaxed. When the breath is coming outside, see that the whole body from top to bottom is relaxed. Chalo, everybody's eyes are closed. Then I will start the meditation. So everybody is sitting straight. The backbone is erect. It is erect, but you are relaxed, aware. And then we will do a acceptance meditation, right? Swikar meditation we will do. So I hope that everybody's eyes is closed.
सभी आंख बंद करके बैठे हैं, ध्यान मुद्रा में। आज आप इसी ग्रहणशीलता को बढ़ाने के लिए स्वीकार ध्यान करेंगे। एक्सेप्टेंस मेडिटेशन। हम बैठे हैं, यह कुदरत को संकेत है कि हमें सब स्वीकार है। इस वक्त वर्तमान में जो भी चल रहा है वो मुझे स्वीकार है। अपना स्वीकार भाव बताने के लिए, दिखाने के लिए हम अपने शरीर और अपनी सांस के द्वारा संकेत देते हैं कि मुझे सब स्वीकार है। अंदर जाती हुई सांस के साथ मन में कहो, स्वीकार स्वीकार स्वीकार। एक बार या दो बार, जितनी लंबी सांस है उस हिसाब से। कभी छोटी सांस है तो एक बार ही कह पाओगे, कभी लंबी सांस है तो दो बार कह पाओगे। नंबर ज्यादा इम्पोर्टेंट नहीं है, एक बार भी स्वीकार मन में कह दिया अंदर जाती हुई सांस के साथ। बाहर जाती हुई सांस जैसे भी जाए, केवल अंदर जाती हुई सांस के साथ कहें स्वीकार। शरीर भी स्वीकार कर पाए, मन भी स्वीकार कर पाए, इसलिए आप स्वीकार ध्यान कर रहे हैं। इस वक्त जो भी चल रहा है, एट दिस मोमेंट व्हाट एवर इज हैपनिंग इज एक्सेप्टेड। जो भी हो रहा है उसे स्वीकार किया जा रहा है। You have to accept five things, पांच बातों को accept करें इस वक्त। Accept the atmosphere, वातावरण को accept करो, observe करो और अंदर जाती हुई सांस के साथ कहो स्वीकार। ये वातावरण माहौल मुझे स्वीकार है। ठंड है या गर्मी हो रही, रोशनी आंखों पर पड़ रही, शरीर पर हवा लग रही, जो भी एटमॉस्फेयर है, हीट कोल्ड लाइट, वट एवर इज अवेलेबल इज द नीड। सो एक्सेप्ट, एक्सेप्ट वाइल ब्रीदिंग इन, सेइंग इन योर माइंड स्वीकार, आई एक्सेप्ट इट। पांच बातें स्वीकार करेंगे। पहले एटमॉस्फेयर को स्वीकार करके आवाजें जो चल रही हैं उन्हें सुन लो और अंदर जाती हुई सांस के साथ कहो एक्सेप्टेड, स्वीकार। ये आवाजें ऐसे ही चलती रहे तो भी फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा। Whatever noise available around is accepted. सांस जैसे भी चल रही है स्वीकार है। छोटी सांस, बड़ी, भारी या हल्की, दाहिनी नासिका से या बाई नासिका से, एक्सेप्ट योर ब्रीदिंग। however it goes. Tisri baat saans ko swikar kar sharir par jo bhi peedaen hai takleefe hain bharipan hai pasina hai dabav hai उसे स्वीकार करेंगे अंदर जाती हुई सांस के साथ स्वीकार कहते हुए मन ही मन में स्वीकार कहना है जो भी असुविधा है वो स्वीकार है शरीर अपना फीडबैक दे रहा है स्वीकार है पांचवा विचारों को भी स्वीकार करें विचार चल रहे हैं स्वीकार है नहीं चल रहे हैं स्वीकार है क्या सोचूं ये विचार है वो भी स्वीकार है कैसे स्वीकार है सांस अंदर जाती हुई स्वीकार की याद दिलाए स्वीकार भाव जारी रखते हुए सभी धीरे धीरे आंखें खोलेंगे
सभी धीरे धीरे आंखें खोलेंगे ले हैव थॉट्स So, as per the time available today, we have done a short meditation. So, it was just a glimpse and to have a practice that how can meditation can help to bring the stress down, right? So, as I said, that meditation should not be of 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. It is not compulsory. It can be of 10 minutes, but with the right understanding. So, this Swikar, acceptance meditation, you can do as a part of your rituals in the morning. If some of us are doing yoga, pranayam, you know, when the pranayam is over, now we are in that state, right now, that state is very beautiful after the pranayams. Those who are doing it, they can understand it. So whenever the pranayam is over, then we can sit for just 5 minutes in that state. And what we can do, this is a practice homework for everybody. That from tomorrow, early in the morning, for 5 to 10 minutes, we have to sit in the Swikar acceptance meditation. Nothing we are doing. What we are doing? For the whole day, minimum 2 incidents, 2 person, 2 things which are unacceptable to us that we feel. So we have to bring them in front of us with the eyes closed. And we just have to ask whether I can accept this or not. And then the answer will come yes. So this is the prior practice or prior thing that we are doing. And whenever the incident will happen, that time you will be ready to accept it immediately. Otherwise, if you are not ready, then it will be a little bit of painful to accept the things right away. So we will do the Swikar meditation practice in the morning and then we will start our day. So this practice you can do from tomorrow or tonight before sleeping also we can do that, right? So these were the 2 tools which I have to give from my side. My side means Tej Gyan Foundation side. So I am just a representative from on behalf of Tej Gyan Foundation. I am a tape recorder. The word we use for facilitators are, we are just tape recorders. We are feeding with the things of Sarshi Ji because he is the actual founder and what we say that he is in that self-realization, self-stabilization state which Mahavir Bhagwan, Buddha Bhagwan achieved after so many years. So his journey was also of 25 years and in 1997, he achieved that state of consciousness. And now from that state of consciousness, he is delivering this, all these things according to this era. Means it is in the language which a small children can also understand like that. So examples are also from day-to-day life and everything. So that was from my side. So I complete from my side. Now I will ask Nidhi madam to wind up the session by 4 o'clock, right? With some sharings from participants that what they learned from today's session, how they are feeling, and whatever are the closing things. I will hand over to Nidhi madam. And thanks from my side. I am here, but still I'm listening to you. Yes, Nidhi madam.
Yes, thank you, sir. All are responding it as excellent session. Somebody had question, but they have yet not asked.
Okay.
Hiren, sir, if you have question, you can unmute yourself and you can ask question directly because question is not there in the chat box.
Yeah, Hiren sir has asked, I think, how we can maintain the consistency, right?
Oh, yes.
So, that is the thing. For maintaining the consistency, we have to start first. That's why I said that never to take challenges for greater timing. That, chalo, we have learned the acceptance meditation today. So, we will, from tomorrow, I will start for 1 hour. I will start for 1.5 hour. It will not happen. So, today we have to start with 1 minute. Right? Today we will decide that tomorrow I will do acceptance meditation only for 1 minute. Next day for 2 minutes. Third day for 3 minutes. Then for 4 minutes. Like that we are programming our subconscious mind, our body-mind mechanism to sit in one place and do the same things, right? So slowly, slowly we have to increase our timings. Sarshiji says that you start with 5 minutes. For one month you only do for 5 minutes. After 1 month, just increase 1 minute, 6 minutes. This will bring the consistency. Consistency doesn't come directly. That also programming has to be done in the subconscious mind. So slowly, slowly, it will be done. Right? So daily you have to do, that is the thing. No matter what. What I do whenever I am cultivating or a new habit in my body-mind mechanism, I make a chart of 1 month. Right now, I'm going through a 42-day challenge to myself for some things, that is like exercise, meditation, which I already do, but other things that I have joined with my health and everything. So I made up a chart. When I tick that in the night, then only I sleep. Otherwise, I don't sleep. I do that first. I tick that. So that way, the reprogramming of subconscious is done and consistency, then it comes. So that way, we have to work on that. Okay, hopefully I have answered somewhat to that question. Yes, Nidhi madam can continue. Yes.
Sir, one more question is there. If some injustice is happening with us, then how to accept it? Repeat it.
Yes, great question. Thank you for asking that. So what Sarshiji has said that when injustice is done, right? So Sarshiji has asked to accept the whole scene. For example, someone has slapped you. This is the half scene. In return, whatever the spontaneous response came from your side, you also slapped him. This is the whole scene. So we have to accept the whole scene, not the half scene. So Sarshi has not said that once someone has slapped you, so you have to take the slap and accept it and keep it like that. No. But in anger or in that spontaneity, you have slapped him. The whole scene, you have to accept it. Why? Because someone has slapped you and you have also slapped him. Then you are in a guilt. I should have not slapped him. So the whole scene should be accepted. So when injustice is done and you are involved in that, that you can do something to avoid that injustice or you can help the person who had gone through that injustice, you have to do that and you have to accept the whole scene. So acceptance is not externally. It is the internal thing for the things, for the incidents, for the thoughts, from which we are in the pain, we are facing the stress. For that relief, we have to accept this. Then now we have to decide how we have to solve it, how we have to approach it, how we are going to go through that. Like that. So please focus on that. We have to accept the whole thing, right? So like that, as Sarshiji said, he says in Indian, so bad nahi jana hai abhi swikar karke. Koi bhi aaya, era gera, humko tappu maar ke chala gaya, aisa nahi hai. We have to take actions, we have to do everything, but the whole scene should be accepted. So it is for the internal things, the power of acceptance is said. Yes, thank you. Yes, Nidhi madam.
Yes, sir. One more question is there. Sometimes believing in ourselves is difficult. How to solve this issue? Believing yes. in ourselves is difficult.
Again, it is of the same type that believing in ourselves. Na, the whatever age is yours and whatever things you have experienced on that experience, we are saying that it is difficult to believe, right? But now we have to reprogram ourselves. We have to take small things and try to solve them. We have to build our confidence slowly. It will not come at a time that we are going to go and solve a big thing. We have to solve it slowly. Right? Small things we have to solve. We have to bring the conviction inside us. We have to build that confidence. And from small things to bigger to more bigger. And that way we have to build up our confidence. First of all, belief is everything. Belief. If you believe that you can't, that you can't. If you believe that you can, you are seeing that you can't, but still you believe I can, then you can. So first of that, we have to give the affirmations right. If you are seeing that you can't believe, then also you have to give the right affirmation. I believe that I can. So many things are there in WhatsApp. Na? Impossible word is then divided into I am possible. So we see so many things on WhatsApp. Okay, thank you. Yes.
Sir, one more is there. How to deal with negative thinking and people around us?
Same thing. We have learned about power of acceptance. So they are negative, right? You are not negative. So right now, just accept the things. If they are not directly affecting your things, leave it. What we do, huh? We are indulging so many things unnecessarily. Mostly in life of others. Why they are negative, they should change. Why they should change? First, we have to change. Sarshi says that when you want to change the whole world, the first person you need to change is yourself. Then the whole world gets changed. Whatever work you have to do to change is here, not there. Everything is here. So on this topic also, there are so many lectures of Sarshi on YouTube. You can just type the keyword and go through that. Okay.
Sir, one more is there. If someone challenged us, we accepted it and the result is not good for us, then how to accept such things?
Right. So whatever the results are also there, that only I said that the whole picture should be accepted. But if you already know that results are not good for you, then why should we go for that? Right. What common sense say that I have accepted the challenge, but the results are not good for me, right? If I understood it right. Okay. So on the first thing, we should not go for it. But if we have taken the challenge, everything is happened. Now the whole scene is right there. So we are accepting the first. Okay, done. Now next time, what the steps I will take before taking any challenge? Will I make some checklist that before taking the challenge, I will see that I am experienced for that or not? If I am ready to accept any kind of result or not? We will make a checklist for next time. This time it is done. Okay, no problem. But these things, when it will come, when I accept the things. If I have not accept, what I will be in guilt. I will be in pain. I will go through again the same thing. Arre kyun kar liya, nahi karna chahiye tha, arre re, so it will start like that. Okay, good.
Sir, thank you for all the answers. If in a minute somebody would like to reflect about how the session went for them, they can unmute themselves. We can go with one person if it is okay.
Ravindra,
okay. Sir. So we are okay with it because this is the last schedule we have. So it would be nice if we hear from some people. Ravindra sir, your video is on. Yes. Would you like to speak? Yes. Anybody would like to reflect on? Okay.
Yes, Anand sir wants to tell something.
Yes.
I think there are no more questions now. So, Hemanji, you have given a very good tool of acceptance to our participants. Already they are multitasking under a lot of stress. And yes. Hopefully, this particular tool of acceptance will help reduce their stress. Okay. So, sir, thank you for this wonderful session.
Thank you, sir.
And Dr. Patankar is also with us. I think in the beginning he was there. Is he there? I would like to mention Dr. Patankar, sir, also here, so, through which we reached you. So, lot of thanks to him also. Okay, Nidhi, madam, let us conclude the session.
Yes, sir. So, sir, I take this opportunity to present a vote of thanks to you on behalf of Information Technology Department. Your presence has made the session wonderful, sir. And the tool would be helpful to all of us in every walk of life. So, yes. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Yes. I also thank Sanjeevani Engineering College, IT Department, Anand sir, Nidhi madam was last time also, so one more time thanks to her.
Thank you.
And Patankar ji, yes. With us in foundation from so many years, so thanks to him that giving us the opportunity, giving Tej Gyan Foundation the opportunity to serve the people who, all around India who are in the education field, which is the most honoring field of our society. So they are the pillars of our future generations also. So it was a nice pleasure and a very nice thing for me to give this lecture on stress management. So hopefully we will meet individually whenever you get attached with the foundation, or sometimes you visit Manan Ashram or in the online events. So there are many online events and shivirs from Tej Gyan Foundation. You can go through the website and YouTube channels also. So I also conclude from here. Thank you very much. It was a nice session. Dhanyavaad. Thank you. Yes. Happy thoughts.
Okay. Thank you, sir.